Aklom TKNO for school.
Welcome back to the Big Horn Breakdown.
I am Vera Grabo.
And I'm Ain Germain.
This month is a special autumn and Thanksgiving edition highlighted by lots of trivia and excitement for the winter ski season.
And of course, student body favorites, regular time.
Aiden, how about this news desk? It's pretty fire.
Yeah, we're almost back in action.
You know what's been fun?
What?
This frigid weather. I just wish it came with a little bit of snow.
Agreed.
I wonder if we can get an update from our weather expert.
We always know what that witch is doing. We always know that witch is going to deliver on time. I'm not hyped to see what he's got going on for us today.
Me too. Let's check it out. Here is Woodge with his new and one-of-a-kind segment, Snow Mania.
Thank you, Woodge.
Woodge with your high school newscast, finding his way back from the snowstorm. As some of you may have known, we got some snow over the past couple of weeks. And with us going into November, that also means that ski season is upon us, with Big Sky Resort opening up on the 23rd of November. For the next 10 days, the weather is looking like it's going to be pretty cold, with our lows being in the 20s and our highs being in the 30s. And over those 10 days, we do have a slight chance of us getting another snowstorm. I hope I don't get lost in that one. I'm Max Widger with your high school news, trying to find his way back to the newsroom. I'll catch you next time.
Dang, Woodge, looking good out there in the cold.
Seriously, he's on it with the exclusive weather know-how.
All this talk about snow reminds me of a hilarious joke.
Oh, I'm sure. Let's hear it.
What is a snowman's favorite kind of cereal?
This better be good.
Ice Krispies. Jeez, okay, I thought it was good.
I expected much, much better. Anyways, a couple of days ago, we went over to the elementary school to see what they thought about Turkey Day.
Let's check it out. What is your name and what grade are you in?
My name is Lachlan Clark and I'm in fourth grade.
All right. What are you grateful for this year?
My family.
That's great. Apple pie or pumpkin pie?
Pumpkin pie.
What is your favorite Thanksgiving food?
Mashed potatoes.
Nice. Cranberry sauce, yay or nay?
Yay.
Okay, I like it. What is the first run you'll ski on Thanksgiving?
I don't know.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Vera Grabo, and who am I here with today?
Judah.
All right, Judah, I have a few questions for you. What are you grateful for this year?
I am grateful for all the food that I get.
Okay, apple pie or pumpkin pie?
Pumpkin pie.
And what is your favorite Thanksgiving food?
Turkey.
Nice. Cranberry sauce, yay or nay?
Yay.
All right, and what is the first run you will ski on opening day?
Either Harbor's Half Pipe or the Bowl.
All right, thank you.
All right, can I please get your name and what grade are you in?
My name is Mrs. Brownie, and I am the school counselor over in the elementary school.
What are you grateful for this year?
I am grateful for my health. I am grateful for all the wonderful things that we have here at this school. I'm grateful for you guys, that you guys get to do this fun newscast that I love so much, so yeah.
All right, what is your name and what grade are you in?
I am Jackson Ballard, and I teach fifth grade.
All right. What are you grateful for this year?
I'm just grateful for a wonderful class and just this beautiful location we're at.
Awesome.
Hi, can you give me your name and grade, please?
Anita Romine, graduate.
Got it. What are you grateful for this year?
Health and being with you guys every day.
Nice.
Thank you, everyone, for your participation in Turkey Trivia.
Whoa, I'm confused how no one's favorite food is Thanksgiving dinner rolls.
Ooh, that is definitely a fan favorite at my house, and a big yay for cranberry sauce.
Anyways, the National Honor Society's fall food drive is up and rolling, and we would love to see those boxes full of canned, non-perishable Thanksgiving items.
I know I'll be donating.
Thank you to anyone in advance who will donate. The local food bank loves the continued support.
On to the the next topic, let's get a quick update from our sports professional on all playoffs and upcoming sports seasons, Samantha Ayers.
Hello, LPHS students. I'm Samantha Ayers, back with another Bighorn sports update. Both our football and volleyball teams wrapped up their season with a strong performance in the playoffs. Lady Bighorns advanced to the last day of divisionals, picking up their first Class B win, and even taking some sets off of the tougher teams. As for our football boys, they played an outstanding game away at Fort Benton. Despite the cold, the Bighorn football team fought until the very end, falling just short of a victory. Congrats to both teams for a fantastic season. Up next, we have some interviews with some players and Coach Squillis.
Jose Chara, how do you feel the game against Fort Benton went?
Towards the beginning, it was really going good for us.
But what are you looking forward to next year?
Earn our place in the playoffs again.
Awesome, thank you.
I'm here with Addie Balanowski, who plays for both our JV and varsity volleyball teams. Addie, what was your favorite JV game this year and why?
My favorite JV game was probably the West game at the beginning of the season because we really played well in that game and started the season off strong.
Awesome.
And how do you feel that both teams performed throughout the season and at districts?
Both teams got a lot better as the season went on, and I was really proud of the varsity. And we played really well during districts, and we ended up winning our first district game, which was really cool to watch.
Awesome. Thank you.
I'm here with Mr. Squillis, who helped coach the football team this year. Mr. Squillis, what was your favorite moment of the season this year?
Of this year's football team was our game during our game against Sims, where everybody played a complete game, and as a team, we performed wonderfully. And so it was great to see the boys do that.
Yeah, and then what was your best moment?
That's
not what the question was.
Best moment was when my children were born. Are we done?
Thank you, coaches and athletes, for an amazing season. Those were some fun interviews. This is also a reminder to register for boys and girls basketball teams, and it's still open. It's such a fun way to spend your winter competing and making friends through the team. Aiden and Vera, back to you guys.
Thank you, Samantha. Vera, are you ready for the ball of season?
Yes, senior season is gonna go crazy.
State bound for sure.
Why stop at state? Well, we could just go straight to nationals.
That's a great plan. And now the segment everyone has been waiting for.
Are you sure about that?
About 57.3% sure, so basically everyone.
All right then, here is the new and improved version of Regular Time.
Welcome to Regular Time.
This month,
we're doing a driving PSA.
We know there's a lot of young drivers coming up in the high school, so Coulter and I are going to teach you guys the do's and the don'ts of driving.
Okay, so first, you need to learn how to sit in the car. We'll show you a few ways how to not do that.
This is how you really want to get into a car.
This is a clear don't.
Now this is a clear do of parking because you're in the yellow line.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Here are a few more things you might want to avoid.
Listening to music while you drive.
What are you doing? Turn this off!
Another big part of driving is signaling, to let people know that you're turning. So usually when you signal, you want to be about half a mile away from your turn. You can never be too safe while driving the car.
Okay, our last pro move is filling the tank. So we're going to remove the nozzle after paying. Select what gas we want. Open this up, throw it in.
Mm-hmm. Wow, Coulter and Ulick, I really enjoyed this new version.
I feel very enriched in the culture of Lone Peak High School.
Okay, so we have a pretty exciting new addition to the Bighorn Breakdown.
Here is the wonderful Abby Meredith
with Bighorn Trivia.
Good morning, Lone Peak Miners and Bighorns! I'm your dashing, cunning, and devilishly handsome, Abby Meredith, bringing you the newest, hottest off the press, Bighorn Trivia, featuring Brady Johnson, who once beat up a baby kangaroo.
He bit a kangaroo!
He was bit by a baby kangaroo.
Yeah.
And we have Cash, who once won the 171st annual hot dog eating contest in Louisville, Kentucky. And we have Mr. Harder, who once won a Michael Jackson dance competition against Bruce Willis, who then had to buy him lunch. Now, my wonderful contestants, today is going to be a nice and wonderful fair competition in which you three will answer three multiple-choice, hot-off-the-press questions featuring the latest in etymology and the local hottest federal statistics about our school spirit. McVeigh, if you would, the first question. Now, here we have our first question. What rank does Lone Peak High School have in college readiness for the state? I think I heard a Harder.
Oh, a cash.
What does he say?
Can I get my choices back up, please? So, when we look at these choices, we have 1, 2, 5, and 10.
Correct.
As Mr. Packer told me, you know, you want to eliminate the choices that just don't seem correct. 5, no way. 10, no way. So it's really between 1 and 2. And, you know, with the confidence I have in this administration, with this lovely guy right here, I'm going to have to go with 1.
1, all right. And just in case, Harder, Brady, what are your answers?
I'm going to go with number 2. We are a Class B school, and often the population is a bit smaller. And I think we're almost to the mark of 1, but I think 1 was thrown in there as one of those, like, throw-you-off things.
Mm. What about you, Johnson?
I think I'm going to have to go with 1.
1?
Yeah.
Well, contestants, I have to announce that Cash Beatty got it correct. Number 1 in the state as of the beginning of this year in college readiness. Cash, that gives you 1 point against Johnson and Harder, 0. Well, let's go on with the next question, McVeigh, if you would. What does Ophir in Ophir Elementary mean? I think I saw Harder.
It comes from the Mormon book, The City of Gold.
Correct! Sorry, Harder got it so correct I couldn't even argue. It goes along with the Mormon and biblical implications of an unknown location, land of location, however one that is rich in gold and wealth, which can be mirrored by that of Montana's reputation as the treasure state. And as you can see, our contestants have already looked into our third and final question. How many students are currently enrolled in our high school? I couldn't see who was first. Brady, what's your answer?
136.
What about you, Cash?
Harder. How many kids are in your average of your class size?
13.
13 times 56? I'm going to go 86.
All right.
I think I'm going to take 117. It's just resonating with me right now. 117.
Well, contestants, I certainly didn't expect this, but none of you were correct. As of the beginning of this year, we have 109 students currently enrolled. This makes us currently at a tie between Cash and Brady Johnson. To really settle it, why don't we go for a thumb war?
Oh. 1, 2, 3, 4. I declare a thumb war. 5, 6, 7. I don't know the rest of it. Go.
All right, who's going to win? It looks like Cash is going in with the arm motions, and we got Brady Johnson throwing him off. Oh, I think we're seeing some cheating action here. Oh, it is tense in the newsroom. Oh. All right, Cash, keep that elbow down. We don't want any unsportsmanlike conduct. Oh, almost got it.
No.
And I think that settles it. It looks like Cash Beatty has pinned down Brady Johnson and my lovely contestants. For winning, you receive this one of a kind, highly sought after, free lunch ticket. Enjoy cash. Well, I think that wraps it up. Back to you guys.
Wow. I don't know if I'm impressed or bummed by the results of that.
I was thinking the same thing. I would have gotten maybe one, correct?
Well, thank you, Abby.
And to all of our listeners, if anyone has any fantastic and incredible ideas, please let us know. We want to make this the best that we can.
And some better joke suggestions would be appreciated.
Breaking news!
Breaking news.
What? Just last night, the school board approved hats to be worn in school. Aiden, could you, at the board meeting, could you please explain the rules of the of the new hats?
So basically, you are now able to wear hats on any day you'd like, except for days of remembrance, such as 9/11 or Veterans Day, such as Veterans Day, which is technically on Saturday, but the day is celebrated on Friday. So you're not able to wear hats on Friday. And you also some teachers reserve the right to take it off when necessary if they don't want it in their classroom.
Thank you. All right, everyone. I am Vera Grabo.
And I'm Andrew Main.
And Will.
We'll catch you next time.
On the Bighorn Breakdown.